is one of the highest Islamic scholars, or he is a Christian man, you know why?
Right, the thing is, Ibn Kathir used a lot of weak hadith, he said so himself, and Israelite stories. I mean, his stories of the prophets, Ibn Kathir, you know, he used them freely, right? So he's not that reliable a source that you're making out. You know, if he said, talks about flying carpets, you know, if the wind is blowing in one direction.
Listen, dummy, listen. Everything is funny about their religion. They say this is Israeli. This means there is an Israeli stories in the Quran too. If they were able to add stories to the explanation of the Quran, they can add anything to the Quran. You see, when you expose them, and you know what? If it is an Israeli story, why Ibn Kathir is adding Israeli story? He's an Israeli, he's a Jew. What's wrong with Muslims? It sounds like the Jewish, they are screwing you all over. Is it funny? Why the Muslim is putting Israeli story in their book? You don't mind. Change you to bring me a proof saying that this is an Israeli story. Challenge, you're mine.
No, we were talking about Ibn Kathir, and he has used Israelite stories. He has said so himself, and that's a fact. And he has also used, he has said so himself, he has used weak hadith. But the point, really, I'm making here is that, you know, a person who says that, who criticizes the Quran and uses a word like crap about it is not a Muslim. That person in your video was an Arab Christian, wasn't he? Your mic.
Who is the Arab Christian? Who is the Arab Christian, sir? Your mic.
I saw an Arab Christian in a video of yours, in a YouTube or something video of yours, where he refers to, God forbid, the Quran. You know, he uses a word which a Muslim would never use for the Quran, right? So he was obviously an Arab Christian, wasn't he? Your mic.
I don't know you are talking about, who cares. I have more than 6 trended videos. And you are the most dummy Muslim ever I saw between all the Ahmadiyya. And this is telling me why you follow someone, he died in the bathroom in the top of his pupu. No, we are trying to find out how we can debate those Muslims. We show them from their books what they say to us, nothing. And look how he's changing the topic. I don't know he's talking about who is. He was a Christian, the light. He was a Christian. Ibn Kathir was a Christian. You mind?
Now, I did not say Ibn Kathir was a Christian, but a person who is presented as a Muslim, but he's actually using wrong words about the Quran, is obviously not a Muslim.
Give me the video, and let us see what is the wrong words. Is that fair, guys? Who is the Muslim? Who? Give me his video. Don't I need to know you're talking about who you are?
Never mind. The important thing is that Ibn Kathir is not.
Now, never not mind. I thought you have something against me. Now you never mind. So why you mention it if it's never mind? Let us go back now. As long as this is your wish. Listen. Let us open the Quran and go to more than one explanation. Cool, guys? We will go, not to, maybe Ibn Kathir is a liar. Maybe he's a Jew. You never know. These things happen, man. Let us go and see in different book, like what? Like Al-Jalalain. How you explain to me Al-Jalalain, he himself saying it is a flying carpet too? You might.
Well, you know, I believe in the Quran, not in every commentary that's written. Okay, so
you're a liar. You are a liar. Where is the story you told the Quran? There is no ship. You just made up a story to cover your ass, which is a smelly one. Read the word in Arabic. Want you? I do not know Arabic. I am like your prophet. I cannot read. I applied to be a docent and they told me you have to know how to read, how to write. I said, huh? Since when? A teacher for 1 billion human being, he don't know how to write, how to read. They accepted me now. Curious. Listen. Whatever we show you, you say those are the scholars. Because simply you are not a Muslim. You are an Ahmadiyya. We can go to any Islamic room now and we ask them, what do you think about Ahmadiyya? They will say to us, they are not Muslims. And you are not. You are not. Now let me ask you, as long as everything for you, either you will say to me it's a metaphor, or you will say to me it's a cheesecake. Did your prophet fly in the top of a flying donkey to the seven heaven, or he did not, according to Ahmadiyya? You're mine.
Well, we believe it was a spiritual journey. Now, with regards to, you know, he passed away on his bed with the name of God on his tongue. And what did they tell are lies, you know, about him. And
so the Muslim Sunni are a bunch of liars. Is that what we understand? The Muslim Sunni, they are lying about him flying at the top of a flying donkey. You're mine.
No, that is a vision, spiritual journey about a horse. I'm talking about passing away on his bed. Those anti-Ahmadiyyas, they tell lies.
No, he did not pass away in his bed. He passed away in his bathroom. And simply, he fell down in that hole. You know where? I don't want to tell you. You know exactly what I'm talking about, right? This is how it is. Now listen, did your, what's his name? Ahmed Mirza. Do he have any miracles? Do he have any miracles, you might?
Yes, his prayers were answered. Have you heard of John Alexander Dewey in America? John Alexander Dewey, you're mine.
No, I don't know who is this guy. What happened with this guy? This guy, he used to have a problem with his sexual life, and this man, he prayed for him, and he is, you know, tell me, what I don't understand. You're mine.
John Alexander Dewey was a hostile Christian, and he said that he would, all he had to do was to stamp his feet and these Mohammedans would be destroyed. And there was a contest with Ahmed alayhi salam, and John Alexander Dowie died a miserable death. You can do a search for him, John Alexander Dowie. He made a place in America called Zion. And, he died a miserable death thereafter. So you can do a search for John Alexander Dowie, and at the same time, Mirza Ghulam Ahmed. And the Boston Herald wrote in the newspaper, "Great is Mirza Ghulam Ahmed the Messiah."
So let me understand what Mirza, he did to this man. He prayed for his death. Mirza, he prayed, he did pray that this guy should die, and this guy, he died, you're mine.